छोरों को प्यार, बड़ों को प्रणाम, नमस्कार, सत श्री अकाल, आदाब। आज सिडनी में जो मेरे साथ पर्सनैलिटी बैठी है उनका नाम लेते ही सबसे पहले पेट में चूहे कूदते हैं, उसके बाद मुंह में पानी टपकता है। जी हाँ, आई नॉर्मली कॉल हिम शेफ ऑफ द सेंचुरी, यू गेस्ट इट राइट, संजीव कपूर। संजीव जी, वेलकम टू सिडनी।
थैंक यू वेरी मच। थैंक यू।
यू नो, एज अ सेड, यू नो, सेलिब्रिटी शेफ ऑफ द सेंचुरी संजीव कपूर, यू नो, इट्स एन ऑनर एंड प्रिविलेज। ब्रेन, थैंक यू सो मच। You've been the first celebrity chef. When did you realize that you want to be a chef?
Well, actually, when I got into the profession, that's when I realized. Because as a child, I didn't even know who a chef was. बचपन में तो पता ही नहीं होता कि chef क्या होता है।
हर माँबाप को चाहिए engineer बनेगा, doctor बनेगा, IAS बनेगा।
पता ही नहीं होता। Chef भी कोई can be a profession. So हम तो मसाला डोसा समोसा वो एक ही पंजाब स्वीट हाउस में खाते थे, तो हमारे लिए तो शेफ वही होते थे। सो वंस आई स्टार्टेड लर्निंग दिस प्रोफेशनली, दैट्स व्हेन आई रियलाइज्ड दैट अच्छा, ये कुछ अलग है, ये कुछ हो सकता है, इसमें करना चाहिए।
एंड प्रोबब्ली यू बीन द पायनियर टू हैव दिस सेलिब्रिटी शेफ्स कॉन्सेप्ट टू बी स्टार्टेड इन इंडिया।
इफ यू क्रिएट बॉडी ऑफ वर्क विच इज़ वर्थ सेलिब्रेटिंग, तो हर कोई सेलिब्रिटी शेफ हो सकता है। बट आजकल मैं देखता हूँ कि लोगों को सेलिब्रिटी शेफ बनना होता है। मैं सेलिब्रिटी शेफ नहीं बन सकते, पहले अच्छे शेफ बनो, फिर बाद में क्रिएट बॉडी ऑफ वर्क विच इज वर्थ सेलिब्रेटिंग, तो अपने आप सेलिब्रिटी शेफ।
सो लेट योर वर्क स्पीक्स लाउडर देन द वर्ड्स। सो व्हाट इज द फर्स्ट मेमोरी ऑफ योर करियर दैट कम्स टू योर माइंड?
ओ मेनी,
द फर्स्ट मेमोरी ऑफ योर करियर, यू नो,
बहुत सारी मेमोरीज हैं जिसमें, बट इनिशियली जब पहले दिन व्हेन आई वाज वर्किंग आई वेंट टू डू अ प्रोफेशनल किचन, और तो हमने कहा चलो जाके खाना बनाएंगे एंड विल कुक दिस। सो फर्स्ट डे वी हैव गिवन अ बकेट विद अ क्लीनिंग सॉल्यूशन, मॉप्स टू क्लीन द फ्लोर्स एंड द टाइल्स एंड एवरीथिंग। हमने सोचा शायद मे बी हाफ एन आवर, दैट्स व्हाट वी हैव टू डू, बट फर्स्ट few days was only that, and that's when you realize that, oh my god, is this for real, this is what you want to do. But then you start to realize ki ye jo cheeze hain ye bahut important hain, aur this is something that is real learning. So first memories jo hai wo safai ke sath mein thi, wo cooking ke sath mein nahi thi.
So probably they were checking the patience, ye jo students aaye hain ye kab tak.
नहीं, ये तो एक्चुअली इन टर्म्स ऑफ व्हेन यू आर कुकिंग, हाइजीन इज सो इम्पॉर्टेंट, पर्सनल हाइजीन इज सो इम्पॉर्टेंट, एनवायरनमेंट दैट यू आर, वो सारी चीज़ें जो हैं वो बहुत इम्पॉर्टेंट होती हैं, एंड यू स्टार्ट टू वैल्यू देम, एंड व्हेन यू स्टार्ट टू लर्न, इफ यू पुट दैट अप फ्रंट, दैट्स द बेस्ट थिंग दैट यू कैन डू।
यू नो, नॉर्मली आई आस्क, यू नो, टेकिंग बैक टू द चाइल्डहुड, यू नो, देयर वुड बी मेनी फॉन्ड मेमोरीज, बट व्हिच इज द वन यू वांट टू रिलिव out of that?
See, nostalgia is such a great thing, and all the memories that you have as a child related to food are that you live with forever. Foods that you at times take for granted, foods that you didn't like, that also you remember, and definitely the foods that you remember. I can say that in simple fun of eating all the seasonal things which are in season. My mom is a vegetarian, so more vegetarian seasonal food. So even now we would look forward, even now I look forward to a good Punjabi style curry made by my mom, because that's what we used to have every Sunday for lunch.
Kadi chawal.
Yeah, kadi chawal. So it's funny that how each day of the week was predictable. It was kadi chawal for Sunday lunch. For Saturday it used to be chana. Rajma chawal, whenever there was any celebration, I would say that there would be rajma chawal. And matlab rajma ani. मोटी चोल खांदे सी
ऐसे, यू नो, द मोमेंट इट कम्स टू पंजाबी सेलिब्रेशन द फर्स्ट थिंग इज ईट ईट एंड ईट,
ऑफ कोर्स,
है ना। आई थिंक 10th ऑफ अप्रैल टुडे इज योर बर्थडे, सो ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ द होल टीम्स ऑफ फिजी टाइम्स, फ्रेंड्स वर्ल्ड टीवी, wish you a very happy birthday.
Thank you.
And it happened to be my daughter's birthday as well on the same day.
You wish her a very happy birthday.
तो जैसे जैसे मुझे बताया आपका बर्थडे मैंने कहा चल इसका मतलब वो भी कुछ बनेंगे. You had a Khana Khazana, which was a super duper hit. Where did the idea come from?
So there was a new TV channel which was being launched, the first cable and satellite television channel of India, ZTV at that time, and they had many shows, and one of the shows that they decided was on food, and I was working as a chef in a hotel as an executive chef, and they came to me with a show, and that show at that time was called Shriman Bavarchi, and I refused. I said I don't like the name of the show, Shriman Bavarchi, and from there then I suggested a new name, which was Khana Khazana, and so as a concept, I'm sure it was the producer director at that time of that show, who's now a famous filmmaker, Hansal Mehta.
Oh yes, yeah, oh yes.
So Hansal, I would say food shows idea on ZTV was his idea, but Khana Khazana as a name was something that I gave.
You know, basically Khana Khazana, Sanjeev Kapoor are synonyms nowadays.
Right.
Indian food has already become too popular in the world, and you are one of the key reasons to making it popular by bringing it on the showcase on bigger platforms. How do Sanjeev Kapoor rate his own journey?
So my journey, as I say, that it's been, even if I had to clean for first few weeks, even if I had to spend many sleepless nights, even if I had no sleep at times, even if I went through a lot of struggle, I still say it's been the whole journey been like a bed of roses, because I have enjoyed the whole journey. I have loved what I have done. I still do. So for me, there's not been a day where I have where I've regretted. There's not been a day where I've said, "Oh my God, where have I landed?" Maybe at that moment I did, but as I look back, I think it's been dream learning, living. It's been something that I have enjoyed, and I think that's what keeps me going.
Wonderful. So struggle has been key to the successes as well. So I normally say, you know, there's no shortcut to success. Struggle is must. That's what you've gone through as well. What are the main factors of success in your journey?
So success is, I think the rules are same.
There's no shortcuts.
Of course, there's no shortcut. All the boring things that your school taught you, all the boring things that your parents taught you, they stay true. I would say that for any success, you have to make sure that you follow all the principles or the value system that which includes hard work, honesty, integrity, all those discipline, all of that is a must, and in that you have to have the ability to look beyond what most people can think, which is a job of a leader, which is if you can learn to lead, which means that if you have the courage to do what others may think, oh my God, should I do it, should I not do it, and you actually go ahead and do it, then
more the risk, more the returns.
Correct. So then you have the chances of so if you have the courage to stand out, then the chances of becoming outstanding are higher. So that's what I believe in, and I have always I've taken my chances. I've made sure that I open the door whenever there's an opportunity knocking on my door. I'm always there at the door, open the door. I just don't wait that someone will open the door for me. No. If I come to this studio, you have not come to me, I have come to your studio, right? So this is when an opportunity knocks, you go and make sure that you take that opportunity. Some people look at the size of the opportunity, but opportunity is such a thing which is always hidden. You don't know whether it's big or small. So don't estimate, under or overestimate the opportunity. Opportunity and opportunity is an opportunity.
And once again, humbled and honored to be sitting next to you. Sanjeevji, wonderful.
Thank you.
number of recipes have come out of your hands, you know, the amount of food that you have cooked so far. What's your favorite food?
I eat everything. My favorite is anything that is now. I don't believe in something which I have eaten earlier, I will eat. I believe that what I will get now would become my favorite for now. Because otherwise, having anything favorite is boring, because that means that you have to have that over and over over again, and that's not how life works. We also are not here forever, right? So to have anything, be it food, person, place, anything, is boring. So let's make sure that my favorite, I say, is now. And that can be food, place, people, everything.
Talking about the places, right? With the amount of workload that you have, the amount of commitments you have, always traveling, working, busy with the schedules. Do you ever get a time for any holidays in between?
So if you can learn to enjoy the moment, which is now, you're always enjoying. So that you don't need
a fixed destination
and say, oh, this is my time for holiday. What I work, when I'm working also, I'm enjoying, right? So I'm in Sydney, so-called for work, but my family is also here. And so I'm enjoying the way I would enjoy Harbour Bridge, Opera House. I'll enjoy this interview also. So what do you call work? It's for me, I don't keep that.
No, we call it working holidays. Your holidays are
whatever.
Working holidays.
I'm always working. I'm always on holidays.
You know, you have managed to win the heart of millions of viewers on the TV and off TV as well. What would be the message to all your viewers?
Well, I would say that do what you believe in, what your heart says, and stay true to that, no matter what. Things change, but be consistent with what the value system that you have. And life is tough, life is difficult, but if you start believing in power of now, then everything is easy. It's you enjoy the moment, you enjoy and focus that on everything that is good. Unfortunately, our mind at times tells us and loses its way, and we start seeing things not from a positive way of mind. We start focusing on anything that is not good, but same thing, it's the glass half full or half empty. So I would say that it's better to look at all the flowers that bloom. Not look at what's not right in the world. Let's focus and collectively make the power of positive thinking so much bigger that the whole negativity starts to become smaller and smaller. And us who can do it, it's what we believe in, and it's possible. I can tell you that I can live with everything that is good. Forever, that's what I believe, and I can say that if I can do it, you can do it, everyone can do it.
So dream big, achieve big. So you
everything whatever you think you can do, you'll be able to do. So don't restrict anything, no negativity in your thoughts. Once you start to look at things from a positive way of mind, everything will work for you. And it's very easy. It's not difficult.
It's only taking an initiative is the difficult part. But once you've taken it,
that it'll be done. It can be done. It will be done. That's it.
Perfect. Perfect. So that was the message for the viewers. Now coming on to, there are thousands of young fellows who aspire to be Sanjeev Kapoor or come somewhere close to Sanjeev Kapoor.
So my message for them is: don't be Sanjeev Kapoor. Be bigger, better than Sanjeev Kapoor.
Wonderful. Wonderful. Wonder Chef, that's a brand, world-class cookware and appliances, recently launched in Australia.
Sure.
Tell us something about it.
So Wonder Chef, it was a dream because I believe through my show Khana Khazana when I first started, and then Food TV channel when I started, I realized that I was influencing, especially in India, I was influencing many women. And what was happening was that while I was teaching them how to cook, there was a lot of independence that they were getting through that cooking, and in some sense it was emancipation of women that was happening. And I realized that if I can create more opportunities for them, that'd be better. So I thought of something with our current MD and managing partner of Wonder Chef, Ravi. Both of us, we realized that we could create something where we would teach women how to cook, and we also embedded some products which they could sell and earn more money. And that idea worked well. So it initially started as a program for women to create entrepreneurs through power of cooking, and they could sell some products and make money also. That's how it started. And since then it has grown really well, and I'm happy that now Biren has brought them into Australia, and I'm sure that people would love it in Australia, as it's become one of the leading brands in India. We have been since our inception, actually, we have been the fastest growing brand of kitchenware in India. Year on year, our growth has been so much. So I'm sure that and our products speak for themselves. They when you start using them, you fall in love with those products. They are just products that you will say you like to cook in. And we built Wonder Chef over three pillars, which we say taste, health, and convenience.
Taste, health, and convenience.
So anything that you cook in Wonder Chef products would turn out to be tasty, will be healthy, and be convenient. So that's what we focus on. And each of our products, we also help you cook, where we give the recipes, how do you cook? Because otherwise there could be something which you may buy and you say, oh, how do I make best use of it? Because there are things that you buy, but you don't know what to
do. So the recipes comes with the utensils,
yes,
as well.
Yes, most of our products, actually all of our products. And if it is not there, online you'll get.
Perfect. And the Khazana brand spices, pickles, ready to cook, and chutney is also launched in Australia.
Mm-hmm. Sure. So that's something that we do in a small way, small scale, and we don't produce very large quantities of it as yet. And I'm happy that Australians are getting to taste it. Wherever I travel in the world, and I'm always told, oh my God, we tried it. But now we cannot get it. I tell them, you know what, we only made so much. It's just that I believe that we will start to make them in larger
quantities as well. Yeah.
But as of now, I can tell you, Khazana as products, we put a lot of work on those. But so for example, in our pickles, we have some seasonal pickles, and they get sold like this, and they are not available after a few months.
But by the time
I can't do anything, because I don't want to use anything which is not in season. I don't want to do so. I would say that if you see a pack or a bottle of Khazana products, buy immediately, because the chances are that. Because that's the experience. I know I travel to United States and Canada, and I get this complaint, and my team keeps on saying, let's make more.
It's a good problem to have.
It's a good problem to have.
Now, once again, I just wanted to say thank you, Biren, for giving me an opportunity to sit next to Sanjeev ji. So today, we have talked to Sanjeev Kapoor, and I am your Navneet. Sanjeev ji, thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Dream big, achieve big. Gemco Sydney. Any course, any uni. www.gemcoaustralia.com.